Healing is the will of God for you. Healing is the will of God for me. Healing is the will of God, period. We must receive our healing. The healing was part of the atonement. We always talk about the salvation of our spirit being saved, but salvation, according to the Bible, includes deliverance. It includes healing. It includes being set free and walking in divine health and being strong and full of faith in the Holy Ghost. We need to come back to believing that it is God's will to heal. Many people today, they say that they have a sickness and they're suffering for God and that they're doing it for the glory of God. But every time you say that, you are not acknowledging that he paid for it with stripes upon his body. As it is written in the scripture, with his stripes we are healed. We cannot accept Satan's lie that we are meant to stay in satanic bondage of sickness. When Jesus, according to the Bible, went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed of the devil, we must go and do the same thing. He sent us out and he said in Mark 16, he says the believers would lay their hands on the sick and they would recover. There was no ifs, there was no ands or buts about it, but it was that we would lay hands on the sick and they would recover. It's a promise of God. The problem is we don't understand oftentimes. We don't go into the scripture and see what it really says. We go by what some preacher says. We go by what some tradition says. We go by what some religious belief says, but I'm here to let you know the religious system we must go by is the religious system of the kingdom of God, which is a kingdom gospel with power. That's the kind of gospel we must preach. It's a gospel with power. How come countless times throughout the gospels we see that Jesus went to all these different places and multitudes came that were sick and they brought their sick with them and he healed them all? I will give you some examples today in Matthew chapter 4 verses 23 to 24. It says this, and he went throughout all Galilee, teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom and healing every disease and every affliction among the people. So his fame spread throughout all Syria. How many want to spread the fame of Jesus Christ? Then we need to do what got him the results. Hallelujah. And they brought him all the sick, those afflicted with various diseases and pains, those oppressed by demons, those having seizures and paralytics, and he healed them. Matthew, again, chapter 8, 16 through 17, it says, that evening they brought to him many who were oppressed by demons, and he cast out the spirits with a word and healed all who were sick. Not some, but all. It is always God's will to heal if you call on him with sincere and earnest faith and believe in the atoning sacrifice of the Lord Jesus Christ, and that with his stripes we are healed. It is the will of God. If we can believe that as the people of God, that it's God's will to heal us, then we will begin to see the miraculous power of God flow in our lives like never before. I am convinced and fully persuaded that it is God's will to heal you, and God's will to heal your loved ones, and God's will to heal those that are on the streets. It's God's will to heal. Receive your healing today. Hallelujah. According to, again, Matthew 8, and now verse 17, it says, this was to fulfill what was spoken by the prophet Isaiah, quote, he took our illnesses and bore our diseases. Don't you know he nailed our sicknesses and diseases along with our sin to the cross? If we can ever get that understanding in our minds, in our hearts, in our faith, then we will say that every time sickness tries to attack us, we have to resist and say, no, I don't receive it. This was paid for by Jesus Christ, the sacrificial lamb, and I reject all sickness and disease in the name of Jesus Christ, because Satan, you've been crushed under the Lord Jesus's feet, and you have no power over me, for he rose from the grave and said, all power is given unto me. Hallelujah. And then he commissioned us with a holy commission and says, as you go, preach, saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out demons. Freely you've received, freely give. Read that in Matthew chapter 10, verses 7 through 8. Hallelujah. And then We read in Matthew 9 and 35, it says, "And Jesus went throughout all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom and healing every disease and every affliction." Again, it was not just some isolated moment where there was a healing, but it was every sickness and every disease among the people. You see the heartbeat of God in the Lord Jesus Christ as he moves through the people, seeing the sick, seeing the afflicted, seeing the demonized, and saying, "No, my kingdom is here." And notice it says he preached the gospel of the kingdom, because when you preach the gospel of the kingdom, you're saying that this place is now God's domain. This is the King of Kings domain, and there is no sickness permitted here. There are no diseases permitted here. There's not sickness permitted here, but only the overflow and life more abundant. Hallelujah. Again, Matthew chapter 12 and verse 15, it says, "Jesus, aware of this, withdrew from there, and many, many followed him, and he healed them all." Again, Jesus went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Don't you dare try and say that, "Oh, there's some that he left alone." No, there is not one instance in the Bible where somebody came for healing and he turned away. No, he healed them all, even the ungrateful. Think about the lepers. They came and only one came back. Hallelujah. They were all healed, but only one came back to worship. It's because it's the heartbeat of God to heal no matter what. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 14 and verse 14, it says, "When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion on them and healed their sick." Don't you know that Jesus Christ, he has compassion when you're sick, but yet some people insist that they're suffering for God. No, God is suffering. His heart is in anguish when you're not receiving healing and when you're not living an overcoming life. Jesus came to give you life and life more abundantly, and it's the will of God that you would have joy and that you're joy would be full. Matthew 14, again, in verses 34 through 36, it says, "And when they had crossed over, they came to the land of Gennesaret. And when the men of that place recognized him, they sent around to all that region and brought to him all who were sick and implored him that they might only touch the fringe of his garment, and as many as touched were made well." Remember, every single person was made well. He healed them all and turned no one away. Matthew chapter 15 and verse 30, it says, "And great crowds came to him, bringing with them the lame, the blind, the crippled, the mute, and many others, and they put them at his feet, and he healed them." You do not see an instance where he turns them away, but it's his will. It's pulsating through the heart of God, and he's saying, "I will bring healing. I will reverse satanic curses, and I will destroy Satan." And he utterly conquered Satan on the cross. And when you come to this and you realize this understanding, I God forever, yes, praise God, when you get this understanding, you will have the fire of God in your heart, and you'll realize that Satan has come against the church, and Satan has come against the people of God, and Satan has come against the world. Hallelujah. And even those people that do not serve God are still created in the image of God. And every time Satan afflicts somebody with sickness or disease, he's afflicting what God has made in his image, which is our human beings. Hallelujah. It is our responsibility to restore the peace of God, and that's why he sent us out with power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Matthew 19 and 2, it says, "In large crowds." Notice verse after verse talks about the multitudes and how many people there were. It was not a small scale thing, but it was a large scale, because they knew that everybody would get their healing. It wasn't like a church service that we have nowadays where somebody gets healed there and another one gets healed there like it's popcorn. No, when Jesus came on the scene, and when he comes on the scene, everybody should get their healing. People should get out of wheelchairs. People that have blind eyes, eyes should open. People that got demons need to come out. When we get the presence of God deep in the sanctuary, God forever, praise God forever, praise God forever. When we get it so deep, then the presence of God will begin to pierce the atmosphere, and all darkness will flee. Satan will be bound, and people will leave into the power of God. That's what we need to come back to. In Mark chapter 6, verse 56, it says, "Wherever he entered into villages, cities, or the country. They laid the sick in the marketplaces and begged him that they might just touch the hem of his garment, and as many as touched him were made well. In Mark 3:10, it says he healed many, so that as many as had afflictions pressed about to touch him. Luke 4:40. Says this: when the sun was setting, all those who had any were sick with various diseases brought them to him, and he laid hands on every one of them and healed them. He did not turn anybody away, and he did not say, I'm running out of time. No, he stayed there, got the job done. My God, how many times have we prayed for somebody that was afflicted, or they were demonized, or they had sickness or illness, and we pray a little prayer and we say, I guess it wasn't God's will today. Maybe we'll try again next Sunday. No, if we have the Spirit of Jesus Christ flowing through us and we understand his will to heal, then we will stay there until the job is done. We will stay there until that thing breaks. We will stay there until the miracle comes. We will stay there until God's will is done and Satan is defeated. We have to contend. We have to earnestly fight and resist the devil. We have to oppose him and say, you will not have this. This is God's property, and I refuse to let you have this property. And child of God, this is God's property. Healing is promised to them, and I defy you, Satan, by the living God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Luke 6:19 says, and the whole multitude, again, the vastness is incredible, sought to touch him, for power went out from him and healed them all. The dunamis went out from him and healed them all. The same dunamis that we received the power, hallelujah, in Acts 1:8, when the Holy Spirit comes upon us, that kind of dunamis, hallelujah, that kind of power. Luke 5:17, it says, now it happened on a certain day, as he was teaching, that there were Pharisees and teachers of the law sitting by, who had come out of every town of Galilee, Judea, and Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was present to heal them. Guess what? God's power, the power of Jesus Christ, is still present to heal, and he lives inside of you, and it's time to let him go to the outside and touch everybody around you, so that wherever you go, the healing virtue of God begins to flow and touch others. It's time we shake the world. Look at all the calamity of the pandemic. Look at all this chaos that has happened. It's time for us to rise with the power of God and rebuke the devil and say, no, we refuse to let you have your way, Satan. Jesus Christ is the victor. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Luke 9:1, Jesus commissions the 12 disciples, and it says he called them, his 12 disciples, together and gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases. There's no way that Satan can stand against the church, because God has endued us with power from on high. He has resurrected the Lord Jesus Christ, and now we have that conquering spirit inside of us to fight and defy satanic logic and all his satanic devices and all the demonism in this world. We have to defy it against all odds, no matter what people say. We must stand against sickness and disease and say, God's will is to heal you, and I'm here to announce the kingdom, and in the kingdom of God, which is at hand, there is no sickness or disease. So in Jesus Christ's name, be healed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Luke 9:11. But when the multitudes, again, look at the vast amount of people, when they knew it, they followed him, and he received them and spoke to them about the kingdom of God and healed those who had need of healing. Now, this was not just a ministry that was isolated to Jesus Christ, but he expected his disciples and his followers to do the same. And we today are to go with the same commission that he gave us in Mark 16, to go and cast out demons and lay hands on the sick and see people recovered and see their complete salvation in the Lord. Now, Acts 5:12-16, it says, now many signs and wonders were regularly done among the people by the hands of the apostles, and they were all together in Solomon's portico. None of the rest dared join them, but the people held them in high esteem, and more than ever, believers were added to the Lord, multitudes of both men and women, so that they even carried out the sick into the streets, laid them on the cots and mats, that as Peter came by, at least his shadow might fall on some of them. And the people also gathered from the towns around Jerusalem, bringing the sick and those afflicted with unclean spirits, and they were all healed. Again, it's not just an isolated event. It was not just one here and one there, but everybody was healed just like he saw his Lord do. Hallelujah. Acts 19:11-12, it says, and God was doing extraordinary miracles by the hands of Paul, so that even handkerchiefs or aprons that had touched his skin were carried away to the sick, and their diseases left them, and the evil spirits came out of them. We do not see any indication of an exception, but everybody was healed yet again. And now there was not even contact. There was not even the laying on of hands, but a handkerchief would touch somebody, and a demon would say, my God, that's an anointing handkerchief. We sense the presence of God. I'm out. And we got to come back to that, where we have so much of the glory of God coming over us, our bodies, that it goes into our clothes even. So that when somebody takes pieces of our clothes or a hanky from our little pocket, that when they take it to somebody that's heavily demonized, that the demons cry out and say, I'm out of here. This is what we need again. We need the power of God to flow. Be convinced that it is God's absolute will to heal. Hallelujah. Acts 28:8-9, it says, it happened that the father of Publius lay sick with fever and dysentery, and Paul visited him and prayed, putting his hands on him, healed him. Hallelujah. That's not it. And when this had taken place, the rest of the people on the island who had diseases also came and were cured. The rest of the people, the whole island had a revival, and everybody was healed, because Jesus is no respecter of persons. He came for all to be healed. So you're not an exception if you have sickness and you're listening to this now, or if you have a family member, a loved one, or somebody you know that's sick, or even when you see somebody on the street and they're walking with a crutch or a limp, or there's something wrong with them, or they're in a wheelchair, Jesus wants to heal them. Be convinced, be fully persuaded, that is the will of God. It is God's will to heal. Don't let that blood and the stripes of Jesus Christ be wasted, for with his stripes we are healed. Hallelujah. And I end with this final verse, though there are many more. There's countless numbers of verses that talk about God's will to heal you and that show the very heartbeat of God. Hallelujah. In Romans 15:18-19, the Apostle Paul is writing, and he says, for I will not venture to speak of anything except what Christ has accomplished through me, to bring the Gentiles to obedience by word and deed, by the power of signs and wonders, by the power of the Spirit of God, so that from Jerusalem and all the way around to Illyricum, I have fulfilled the ministry of the gospel of Christ. And I am here to profess unto you, you will never fulfill the ministry of the gospel of Christ until you preach it with the power of the kingdom, with mighty signs and wonders, by the power of the Holy Spirit of God. That's how we need to preach. Oh, give God praise. Worship him. This power is in us. Let's go forth in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God forever. Praise God forever. Praise God forever. Hallelujah.